here we are in the game down here in the bottom left-hand corner of Cloud Kingdom, the map upon which this mayhem will take place. Got ourselves, formerly from the team TSL, he is center on Killer's account. And his opponent in the top right-hand corner, hailing from Complexity, ladies and gentlemen, he's got some excellent publishings from his diary, from his notes on his brain, and his thoughts on life and the pursuit of happiness within esports. Give it up, guys, for QXC.
Yeah, QXC strikes me as a very well-spoken person.
Yeah.
Someone that knows what he's talking about. Well, of course,
kinda like you, Tim.
All in. No.
If you guys haven't seen our newest show, The Twilight Council, Tim is very convicting in it. I felt you were pulling on my heartstrings, man. I feel like we should make like an All-American Reject song about Tim Frazier and his ability to speak to cameras.
Is that the band that did Bloody Valentine? Is that the same band?
I think
no, American Rejects are like
they
Move
did,
Along or whatever.
Yeah, they definitely did Move Along. They did like Swing from the Tangles of My Heart.
What is Bloody Valentine?
That's why that song came to mind.
Dirtbag.
Isn't Bloody Valentine a band?
Is it? I don't know. Those are like the emo songs that's doing like in 8th grade back in the day when I was a youngin'.
No, I don't think it's Bloody Valentine. It's like Something to My Valentine, though.
Well, into builders really
you
quick, guys.
To that stuff.
Looks like we actually have a Raxton down here in the bottom left corner. Mm-hmm. And, of course, a follow-up and new gas. And this is something that if we see Trimaster, we'll see a lot of this, actually. He loves to hide Rax. But what this does, it just kind of throws off your opponent. For the most part, scouting isn't too active in the early game, because for the most part, there's a lot of similar openings, especially in Heartless Swarm. But
yeah.
Here in Wings of Liberty, as you see, we'll have a delayed scout here from QXC. He will pop down into this main. And we actually have a gas follow-up for him after his Rax as well. So a little bit quicker here, I think, for center. I think did he actually go gas first? Because he did that gas really quickly. We were too busy talking about emo band songs.
No.
Okay, so just a tad bit quicker. Following up straight into a Tech Lab here, which leads me to believe that he wants to go straight into Marauder Fast Impact.
Actually, I'm taking a look at that. So Tech Lab is going to be wrapping up here in just a second. And 3:10, it is done.
Let's see it's if it's near Marauder.
Up.
Let's see if halfway intelligent here.
Reaper will start. Expand, it looks like. SCV heading out across the top portion of the map as QXC is currently scouting around center's base. See what he can manage. Yeah, there he does, man. He'll actually see this Reaper. Build time, good 45 seconds. It is going to be a little bit longer. And cancel's actually going to happen here. On supply depot was canceled 75 minerals. Either way, reactor going down, folks. And nice lift there, not allowing him inside, but he still will see this reactor being constructed. However, I did not see red lines around it, so I'm not sure that center managed to get a click on it.
I like the follow-up into the Reaper. He's going to have a decent amount of Marines on the field to deal with the Reaper. It won't be doing that much damage to his natural or his main. Look at him even poising here. He'll be able to put two Marines on this bottom right part of the cliff, and then two in the top left to guard his mineral line. So for the most part, he's going to A, deny scouting, and B, not take too much damage. Two Marines should be able to do a decent amount of damage onto a Reaper as it pops up, and with some micro as well, he could potentially even kill it off.
Yeah.
So follow up into a factory here for QXC, and checking into center, he has followed up into his own very own command center on the low ground. So.
Yeah, and he continued mining mining gas here as well so that he could start up a very quick stim, and this is really one of the only two routes that you ever go when you go with a Reaper expand. I mean, you can opt to instead just take off gas, which is not uncommon as well, or you can continue on it, get this very fast stim, and have a lot of options open to you. In terms of pressuring. So we'll see what Center decides to ultimately do with this. QXC, as you said though, Tim, going for that factory, and he is actually going to manage to pick off that Reaper with relative ease.
Killed off very, very quickly there, and the factory follow-up is actually pretty nice for him as well. He's going to be able to pop in with a couple of Hellions if he wants to go that route. There is, of course, always the starport way that you can go, and he actually does put up a starport right away. Still on one guess. So wondering if he's going to go straight into Banshee without Cloak. We'll see if he actually puts down a Tech Lab on top of that Rax. He's actually got a poise to where he could just flip if he wants to. And looking into center, his two Rax are now following up at the moment, and he has finally followed up into, what is this here in the main that he's creating here? Following up into his factory. It's a weird spot for a factory. Interesting. Usually I see that to a little bit on the left side.
Yeah, I thought, we may have seen some sort of a utilization of an add-on from these barracks, but ultimately center looking like he wants a very straight, I mean, this is like a beautiful main base, because everything over here is just so incredibly protected.
It's away from a scan, too. You have to move your scan to a position to get either A, an idea of what he's going for on the right side of his main, or, of course, what's going on the left side of his main. Everything's kind of really spread out. Here comes the Hellions here, though, from QXC, moving straight into the main right away. Marines will be in trouble here, as they will take some damage.
Oh,
and man. They are lining up pretty nicely. Ooh, a nice pullback from center.
QXC definitely has the potential potential to get some damage in here. Remember, the Reaper expand into Fast Stim. Definitely paying off a little bit for QXC right now as he's getting in some free damage. That Hallion is so low on hit points.
Oh my goodness,
24. He's going to try to line up those SCVs, but ultimately not too much worker damage as of yet. 5 workers killed so far.
Doing a good job of microwing this, so the Hellion will finally fall off there, and there we go. But he follows up with 2 more Hellions. Nice job of harassment here from QXC. He's going to take out the Hellion right away, and suddenly Marine's popping out. They are going to stim and snipe the one Hellion in the back, but 2 more, of course, will be able to do some kiting here. QXC doing a good job of paying attention to his Hellions, but also in the production tab, been following up in macro the whole time, constantly producing 2 SCVs at a time, following up to the double factory. He's going to be going mad here.
Oh, this is so bad for center. He's completely out of units. QXC has done a fantastic job throughout the course of this game, picking off every single one, and that's it, folks.
4 Hellions wins the game. GG. Well done there by QXC. So, I mean, it's a great micro overall. A nice read there, seeing that stim pack, realizing, you know what, he's not going to, A, have that much health overall. He has to use a stim in order to go ahead and engage on me if he wants to. And at that point, he's going to be 10 hit points weaker. And then finally, I just follow up with a couple of Hellion shots, and he dies off. Some nice micro, I should be okay. And he did a really good job of controlling that in the main. Just QXC, he just straight up boss status that. Like,
yeah,
that's all I could say.
I mean, one of the big things there for center, too, was that he did not have a wall off.
That's true.
No supply depots on the ramp made it very easy for the Hellions to get inside. If he had kept things in the natural, he had that bunker in position to deal with the Marines. Hellions could have still gone for a run-by, but a couple of SCBs being pulled and some Marines on the low ground would have been able to deal with that pretty effectively, as long as the Hellions couldn't run and kite you forever, which, with the entire base at their disposal, they can. So, ultimately, center getting knocked out. Next up for TSL would be Value. So, we'll be jumping into that game in just a second, but a quick commercial break your way, folks, and we'll be right back.